二つの感情が生まれて。
The Japan music scene is booming. From rock to rap, dance music to pop, Japanese people buy everything going.
Welcome back again to Suburbia Tokyo Hot 100. With the music that you really want to hear, and I'm its MC, Minutes of the Countdown, Chris Public, keeping you company on this week's top 100 hits from 81.3 J-Wave.
Chris Pepler is Japan's number one DJ. His show is listened to by two out of three young people.
そんなお母様、この本、昨今、早速参りましょう。Suburbia Tokyo Hot 100, here it comes.
Many groups come to Japan first because it's a very good testing ground. Queen was actually first popular here in Japan, Duran Duran. So Japan is a very good test case for a lot of groups trying to go global.
Pop music is a multi-billion dollar business in Japan. To become global superstars, bands know they've got to crack the biggest market outside of America.Gary Stout has produced top British artists Suede and Tricky. He lives in Tokyo and is blown away by the Japanese music scene.
Last couple of years, there's been a dramatic rise in the quality throughout, you know, the Japanese music industry, from, you know, the J-pops to the alternative bands. The quality of videos is much higher. The whole market is much broader. You know, it's...You do, you have your glam. You have your J-pop. You have your hard rock. You have your alternative. You have your techno. And it's all kind of jumbled up together. I enjoy the diversity of it, actually. It's just a very interesting scene. You know, you can't be bored with it.
Western music is supposed to dominate the Japanese market. In fact, they prefer their own artists and listen to less foreign music than the British.
One hears a lot about Japanese bands copying Western bands, but they are developing their own style of rock music. Yellow Magic Orchestra describe themselves as techno-pop.
Japan's most successful export has been techno dance music.The trend started with the Yellow Magic Orchestra, who hit the headlines in the late 1970s. Now, top DJs Ken Ishii and DJ Crush are in demand all around the world.
It's only a matter of time before...One of the techno bands has a single in Britain. Yeah, I believe it'll happen.
Audio Active and Boom Boom Satellites are the most likely bands to make the breakthrough. Some of the most individual Japanese artists are also on the verge of international stardom.DJ Cornelius has worked with Blur and James Lavelle, but the one most likely to make it is 18-year-old Hikaru Utada.
The biggest pop star in Japan, I would have to say hands down, is Hikaru Utada. She only has released one album so far.Her debut album sold close to 8 million albums. She's part of EMI, and globally, of all the EMI-related artists, I think she sold the most albums that year.
I believe someone like Hikaru Utada, if they were singing in English, would sell records abroad. It's just a matter of time before an artist really breaks big.In the West. For me, she is definitely the one who could do it if she wanted to.
There's another girl called Sheena Dingle, who's very eclectic, very popular recently. She's almost like your Japanese Fiona Apple, Alanis Morissette, very underground. Her imagery is very goth. It's very dark almost. Her album has done very well. Her album has sold over 1.5 million.
Just as in the West, some bands are known for their image as much as their music. Lunacy are hugely successful. They've had a string of number one hits and a massive following.
Lunacy is a tremendously popular group. They're part of a genre called visual. They are pretty boys with guitars, with a lot of makeup. But that was in the past, and I think Lunacy has kind of evolved.
The band's guitarist, Sugizo, used to dress in Nazi uniform. He's rejected that style, but his fans still cling to the old image. Japanese fans are truly fanatical in their devotion to their heroes. Tonight, the band are launching their new album with a gig at Tokyo's famous Budokan.
日本の本当に音楽業界ってすごく流行が変わりやすい。ものすごくペースが速くて、リリースのペースもすごく速くなきゃいけない。もし周りの人たちがこのシーンの中でうなしのシーンをどうしてキープできるのっていう疑問に答え、一番いい答えは多分今思い浮かんだけど、まだ始まったばかりだと思ってる。
Just like the Spice Girls, Steps or S Club 7, mainstream pop stars or idols are picked, packaged and produced by record companies. Japan's top promoter, Tsunku, shows his groups to audiences from the first audition.
でもそこにはやっぱり、もしかしたら実は根拠はあるのかもしれないけども、いつも毎回同じカテゴリーでその作戦を実行していったとしても、 同じようにヒットするアイドルグループはできるとは思わないんですよ。 だからもしかしたらそのオーディションの過程でそんなに歌がうまくないような女の子もオーディションの中で訓練していってすごく上手になっていくところをお茶の間側がテレビを見ている人たちが、あ、この子私と同じぐらいの歌の上手さなのに、
オーディションの過程で私が表現できないぐらい上手くなったわって思うことによって短さと尊敬の2つの感情が生まれてくるってことですね。本当に人生が変わっちゃいましたね。それで、まあ、やっぱ最初はいろいろ初めてのことばっかりで大変だったんですけど、今はみんな4人とも慣れてきてすごく毎日楽しいです。
The manufacturing of pop groups has taken a logical step with computer-generated stars outselling their human counterparts. These virtual pop babes sell millions and are regarded as mega sex symbols. Both men and women buy records, posters, and even computer games starring the outrageously proportioned Dream Woman.
What? 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 What?
pop is one of the fastest growing areas in both Japanese music and fashion. Japan has taken the sound from America, but created something new.
Now there's Japanese hip-hop, the rap is in Japanese, and they talk about current issues. These kids that are into hip-hop, they are extremely wealthy kids. They are from unbelievably affluent families. But what these kids told me is that because we are affluent, because we are not part of that machinery, we go to school for a couple of years overseas, lived in New York for a few years, we have that freedom to actually see society. And that way we can perceive the injustices, so to speak. So these kids with parents as politicians will hang out with kids that are truck drivers or construction workers. And that seems to be the unifying source.
Emperor of the hip-hop scene is MC Zebra. He fell in love with the music during a trip to the United States.
俺らみたいな日本語のね、ラップができてから、初めはすごいアンダーグラウンドって時はやっぱりすごい小さな子しかなかったんだけど、最近は結構、渋谷にハーレムっていうところができ、それが2年、3年前ぐらいなのかな、できてからはそこはもう結構ヒップホップの大箱としては、かなりいつも人ぎゅうぎゅうだし、盛り上がってますね。
Dime Star are two rappers with a new form of hip-hop. It combines humor, music, and poetry.
Yes!
これはマスターオブセレモニー MC と呼ばれるマイクの鬼その名のもとに盛り上がるようにマイホーミー導く迷わぬようにフロムザイーストトゥザウェストスキル持つ MC にナフィスペクト
日本語で俺たちの歌いたいことを歌ってればそれは日本のものになるっていうかだから俺たち別にヒップホップに限らず日本はそういうふうにいろんなものを自分たちのものに昇華してやってきてるだから俺たちもそういうふうにだからアメリカみたくやろうとかはこれっぽっちも思ってないし
日本ってねすごくね言いたいことを言わないんだよそれが俺はねそれ良くないと思っててやっぱり言いたいこと言わなかったら国にも良くなんないし、だからみんなその事なかれ主義みたいなのを俺はもうそんなこと言ってられないと思うから俺はそこ変えたいと思ってて、だからそういうことやってるって感じかな
Tokyo's Yoyogi Park is used by performers to strut their stuff. Japan is no longer just a mecca for manufactured pop. Its music scene is amazingly diverse. A sophisticated audience is comfortable with a multitude of different sounds in a fusion of East and West.
The West is becoming more and more like the Japanese market. Record companies, you know, they like manufactured bands. They're easy to sell, they're easy to control.
It's very interesting to see that idol groups are breaking it really big in the United States, which is the biggest music market in the entire world. And here in Japan, the second biggest music market in the world.It's now going towards more uniqueness, towards more individuality, more aggressive, non-conformist acts. Are you ready? Love to